Okay, it's June 29th, 2017. It's 9:38 a.m. Wild mint type plants that we let grow each year. They're not a heirloom thing per se. I don't think. They may be the ones I planted years ago, but I'm not worried about them. A couple sunflowers here. I had three. That might eat that one down there. Put eggshells, crushed eggshells around the tomatoes. And then Demacious Earth. Tracy sprinkled some Demacious Earth on them yesterday. The wind is out here the biggest challenge. But that's to keep the worms off. We got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 peppers in the first row here. And we got all the large 1 pound type of tomato that yield 1 pound of tomato per plant out here. This one was so devastated with brown spot on it, I took all the leaves off by hand, trying not to cross contaminate them. And it's coming back. It seems pretty good. Might be 1 or 2 smaller ones on there. Yeah, I have to get basil. You see how thick this basil is right here? That's been thinned out already. Watch out here. Be careful. Careful. Don't walk on it. Basil helps deter insects also. My wife is Tracy putting them here. Over there on the far end. There. One in that hole right there. One in that one right there. So spread it out so when we get more tomatoes out here. This weekend, after it's supposed to rain tomorrow, it's getting windy too, like a storm's going to be coming. The weather out here with man God is unbelievable. But we'll transfer the three tomatoes that are only about 2 inches tall or so. But, you know, I'm going to put one right here where this bulb digger is, plug, whatever. One there. And I'm thinking one in that hole right there. Not too sure if I want to do it in this hole or the one in the back there. So it'll be three right there. And then we're going to have one there, 4 and 5, wherever the other hole is. And then plus the 7 tomatoes out here. And they're coming out pretty good. I'm going to zoom in. I'm not going to go up to the tomato plant. I'm just going to zoom in and show you. Okay, there's 9 tomatoes on that plant right now. And as I do this, I scan it with my eyes. I see a couple leaves that have some brown spot near the bottom down there. I'm going to have to peel off by hand. I can't do it while I'm video recording, so. But there's 9 tomatoes on this one already. And the flowers, all of them still. There was one on that plant right there. It's strangling itself. I've been trying to slowly pull the branches out because they've been strangling itself. But you can see one small tomato right there too. Focus. And of course with the wind it makes it hard, but it's the stupid ass autofocus. But that's about almost 4 feet tall. That's 4 feet, over 4 feet tall right there. With the 9 tomatoes, 8, 9 tomatoes on it. Again, more basil. Taking out several basil plants and putting them in the holes. The ones with the small tomato steaks, the cheap ones you get at China Mart, that's where we're putting peppers and now basil too. The ones that are like 1 inch by 1 inch is where we're putting out. These are old fashioned tomato steaks. It wasn't part of my mom's swing. There were slats around the seat in the back. After she passed away, the swing sat out here and pretty much in the weather and rotted the seat and all that. We couldn't do much about them. Well, anyway, they were cut in half, so they got 1 inch by 1 inch slots all through here, and I got a bunch in the shed yet. And that's a purple basil that we got from friends at Heirloom Solutions. I mean, I don't know if they want to be referred to Solutions from Science or Heirloom Solutions because they seem like they're a sister company. But we got some of those from them. I mean, they have been so helpful and so generous. Yeah, oh, there's a couple of small basils that were transplanted. Where's that one there? So, garlic over here. Make sure I don't step on this basil. Garlic's doing good. Keep trying to keep the grass. See, it's getting back in there again. Tracy actually sat on his knees out here and pulled this grass out by hand. I'm too heavy, my knees are too bad, and my back's too bad, so I use a pointed hole rake, and that's already cracked. So, because it's cheap shit from China, folks. Everything from China is cheap shit, just like it used to be from Japan. Cheap shit. And we got sunflowers right here growing. A group of them right there. A few right there. And we got Black Beauty zucchini, which is the green. You see that nice one down there? It's about 9 inches, 8-9 inches long. This one here seemed like it was starting to get warm. But these have all been sprinkled, by the way, again, with the Macy's Earth. Yesterday, my wife put them in. So we got three zucchini plants out here. This one's already put out. We've had four or five. We've been eating on them. There's one or two down there yet coming out of the next. Well, she might have got one. Yeah, she got one already that was on there. But there's another one down there. I don't want to move this too much. That one right there. I don't want to move this around if there's any bees on the flowers inside. And the small bees are taking care of pollinating these, so that's a good thing. The broccoli, we had worms all over these things. Again, this is the first time we've actually tried to grow broccoli good. And we had four of them out here. And it's like they're hanging on because it's kind of hot. So same thing with the lettuce. Put it out way too late, but we still have that. Oh, that's a nice looking one there. It's butter crunch, I believe, lettuce. All heirloom, that one. And we have, what is it, one, two, three. So there's four out here. There were like three rows of five of three different types. And then we've got those cucumbers. I had four out here before and they never came about and kept turning. See, that's the thing, we don't have the patience and we keep tilling up the ground and breaking it. So anyway, we have five growing now. Okay, and I planted some sunflowers plus these trellises. We got one there, a small one just came above the ground next to it. And then there should be, I think that might be one right there in the middle. So three, same thing, there should be one coming up here soon. And then we got two back here. One, I can't see on the camera. Again, this is the ingenuity the ingenuity, I guess you'd say, of how they make these things. You have a big screen which you can't see out when it's bright out here. I can't see it. But there's two down there and one's like a triangle. Two there and one in the middle up front. Two back here and one in the middle up front. Help guide the cucumbers. Swiss chard, which I don't know why we don't really eat that, but it was planted here. Nothing. I don't think it's coming. I don't think that's Swiss chard. Purple hull peas. These are descendants from my mom's garden, by the way, that she had. Passed away in 2012 on December 28th at 3:49 p.m. And we had these purple hull peas, and we've been growing them ever since. Watermelon. Cantaloupe. Watermelon. Cantaloupe. And this is a, I can't think of that bean. It's an heirloom bean. It's like a white bean, but it's not quite. And then we got okra. There's two okra up there in that. There's an okra there, so there's five total. One, two, three, four, five, yeah. And then purple hull peas. Did it get stitched? And one of my Abuni hat I bought from China Mart. No, from Kmart.
It got stitched and super glued.
Oh, yeah, okay.
But that don't fray.
Did you double that one up at all?
No, I didn't.
Okay, well.
Can't really tell.
Remember, it says made in China. It's a piece of shit. I don't give a fuck what anybody says. I just got an R rating on this video. Thank you. So I got a boonie hat to be out here in the sun with a strap so the winds out here don't blow it off because it has done that many times. Alright, so the purple hull peas. This is the watermelon. I don't know if we haven't seen a watermelon on here yet. I see over here this is supposed to be a cantaloupe, but there's an actual plant, fruit growing on there. Two of them. Wow. These look like the Waldheim. Watermelon, the elongated ones. Yeah, right there's one. Right in there's another one. You can see the sun shading on it. Oh, and there's another one, three. God, I can't see on here. On the video, you should be able to see that better. Well, there's three going on there. And up front here, see, this should have been the sugar baby, which is a round bowling ball type. We had a 19-pound one last year. But up here, see, these are mixed up, I think. This might be the watermelon. Oh, this is cantaloupe for sure, I know that. This might be the watermelon. I mean, the round watermelon, the sugar baby. But you see that one right down there? We had a 19-pound one last year. It was kind of messed up, too, but trust me, this year it'll be a whole lot better. Anyway, that's enough of that. Black-eyed peas. These are growing like gangbusters. So, you know. In another 2 weeks, we might plant about 6 more of those. You see the pods. So I've already picked off like 4 that were brown tan. Those come out really nicely. They usually have about 10 or 12 peas inside there. This one, no idea what's going on with that. But, see, I planted beans and peas all around here. You see one coming up there. Beans and peas are the primary thing out here in this garden. And the tomatoes are next, and then there's one coming up down there. Over there. Now these all should have 2, I put 2 in each hole, I thought. Right now it's just one growing up there and one growing up in that one. And there's one there, there should be 2 in all of these, like I said. Okay, I planted 2 in each of these. And I only see one starting to come up right there on that side. Same thing with that one right there on the left side. Oh boy, I think these are Cherokee trailer tears. They're purple beans, really nice small beans. And all the other beans up there. Those are the northern bean, white beans. Picked a few of those before. Might be picking some more today. And we're getting that replanted because I'm going to have 4 more areas. I've cut plastic, and plus you see like, okay, focus. Right there where that hole is, right where that fence is, there's a square there. That's where we'll be planting 2 or 3 beans again, so we'll have more. These were all planted too late, so that's why they're stunted their growth, I believe. They're dying off already. It takes about 8 to 10 weeks on most of these beans. But I've already picked a few off here, but it's just maybe 4 or 5. Let me go all the way to the end here. And look at that one, how that looks. And then I planted 2 there. Let me be on this side. 2 right there. 2 right there. 2 right there. See how these are looking, you know. And I blame a lot of times. I think it has to have a way. Look at the brown spot on them. I would make that plant bald if I peeled off 90% of the brown spot. And these are the leaves for the shade. So it's a time thing between now and the next 2 weeks. Most of all those beans are going to be off the pods, and then we don't have to worry. You see, there's 2 there, 2 underneath the fence here that just start going north. And here I just have 1. I thought I have 2. I might just have 1. And that one, and then there's 2 over there. And then we got these giant. I believe that might be a mammoth sunflower. You can look how thick the stem is. Same thing out there. I have different ones. That's the first one to open up. It was opening up. My wife said it opened up yesterday. I didn't pay attention. I must not pay attention to see it. I usually report something like that. But when the sun was setting in the west, which is behind us that way, the sunflower was still facing east. That's I want to say a Titan. I'm not positive, but I believe it's a Titan. Because I have Titan and Mammoth sunflowers are about 90% of what's out here. Then I have the Tatos, whatever it is, the other ones. Some of them only go about 4 feet tall. But the massive heads are the Mammoth. And that might be a Mammoth. I don't know for sure. At least a Titan. Over there by that zucchini is a mammoth. There's 1 or 2 mixed in with that one over there, that group. That grouping right there. So, torch sunflowers are big orange flowers. You get the large winged butterflies and the honeybees and the hummingbirds. One on the corner down there, one right there, right there. Miss Lucy's resting place. Miss CJ's resting place. Oh. Torch. That's a torch right there. You can look at the leaves and see the difference too. You can see how this leaf is like almost like a heart. Almost like a weed, but it's not. And this is your yellow head. it's tight. Small torch coming up. These are two torch sunflowers right here. They'll be real bushy with a lot of flowers on them, and the seeds just drop. I mean, I have a whole 5-gallon bucket full of these heads that have the seeds in them. That's why I usually replant these. So I dug up the back. Oh, see, I should have known while I was over there, but I'm hobble back over here. Had the tiller out yesterday, or the day before yesterday, and I overdid it. And I tilled up a little area in here, and I put a bunch of these regular sunflowers, the torch, and I mean not torch, the mammoth, and the titan sunflowers in that little area right there. And I did the same back here, because this area has no sunflower. I'm getting aggravated with this too. That's why I said I'm just taking the tiller out, and I did about a 4-foot swath all the way down. And I planted all the way down a bunch. And I haven't watered it yet because it was thought to rain yesterday. But of course it didn't. It'll rain when it wants to rain. Man, God will make sure of that. But I'll have a bunch of sunflowers, a whole wall on this north end over here, all the way down. It helps attract bees and the butterflies. And even the, like I said, the hummingbirds, even though we have feeders. The hummingbirds, folks, this year, 2017... Last year we had around 50 plus almost 60. This year it looks like about 25 maybe. And it's the end of June. So you can't say shit if you don't know that something's going on with the environment. Oh, it's global warming. Screw your goddamn global warming. We're going through a cycle. We might be warming up, but it's a cycle. It'll change. It'll go back to cold in about 10 years, 20 years maybe. Gonna put in all these taxes so that the rich people can get richer because they know better and they're just laughing their asses off at you people. I don't know if that's a weed. Anyway, one of the torch sunflower bushes last year, they were thick. We just threw it down in there last year to figure, well, the seeds will come out and everything, but I don't know, this stuff probably strangling it off. Because it'd been nice to have some orange flowers pop up in there, but like I say, the way that is, I don't think it's gonna grow. They're gonna grow. And then I got this one over here on the east wall. See, that's what I'm saying. Like, look down there, you see? See sunflowers starting to come up in there? There's one. There's a couple down there. It's hard to do unless you really do like I did with that tiller, but these are already established and I didn't want to tear all these up, so just let it go and see how this goes this year. If anything else, next year, if next year, I'll till this one like I did the back one on the north side, make a 4-foot swath all the way down. I did it one time at the end of last year, and just thought, well, maybe it won't be so bad later. This is already 18 minutes, so we'll see if YouTube will let this go on there. I should put it at the beginning that this is a long video. If you want, I'm just going to stop watching. I mean, this is just the garden. This is the survival garden for 2017. Again, we're trying. We're really trying big time. So I hope some of you start getting, you know, get going, do something. Plant a few things, if anything else. We've been lucky, blessed, however you want to put it, to have this place where we can put this. The biggest downside is 160 acres of Monsanto corn right up around us. And then it's a total of 300 acres off in the distance. They got soybeans. That's right. Monsanto's the number 2 product. Cotton, number 3. All deadly, poisonous crap. But anyway, I digress. Stay safe, everybody. This summer will be the summer of rage. They will try to assassinate President Trump if they don't, in fact, succeed to. And when that shit happens, all I can say is one thing. Stay the fuck away from here.